This conference will now be recorded.
Good morning, students. Last class, I explained this hydraulic jump in rectangular channel. We discussed this hydraulic jump in the rectangular channel, and in that concept we applied the Newton's second law of motion for the hydraulic jump in rectangular channel. We know that in the hydraulic jump, the specific force at section 1 is equal to the specific force at section 2. In the hydraulic jump at section 1, the water flow has some specific force F1. At section 2 also, the water flow has the specific force F2, and in this hydraulic jump, the specific force at section 1 is equal to the specific force at section 2. Then in the last class, from that principle F1 is equal to F2, we got the equation 2. I explained this equation 2 in the last class. So we discuss about this equation. This equation is from the principle F1 is equal to F2. In that hydraulic jump, the specific force at section 1 is equal to the specific force at section 2. From that we got this equation. Last class I explained the derivation of this equation. 2q square by z is equal to y1 y2 into y2 plus y1. In this equation, y1 is the depth of water flow before the hydraulic jump. Y2 is the depth of water flow after the hydraulic jump. Small q is the discharge of water flow per unit width. We discussed this equation in the last class. Then in the last class, I explained these relationships between the y1 and y2. We discussed these relationships in the last class. And also in the last class, we started this equation for loss of energy in the hydraulic jump in rectangular channel. So last class we started this concept, the equation for the loss of energy of water flow in hydraulic jump in rectangular channel. Very, very important concept. Please everyone follow this concept carefully. This is totally the mathematical concept. So please inform your classmates to join the class. Definitely you will get the question from this loss of energy. So please everyone listen this equation for the loss of energy of water flow in hydraulic jump. Please observe this diagram. We know that in the hydraulic jump there is a loss of water flow. Before the hydraulic jump, the water flow is supercritical condition, high energy. After the hydraulic jump, the water flow is in subcritical condition, low energy. So in this hydraulic jump, the water flow is moving from high energy supercritical condition to low energy subcritical condition. So in this hydraulic jump, there is a loss of energy of water flow. We are going to discuss the equation to find out that loss of water flow in the hydraulic jump. Then before the hydraulic jump, the depth of water flow is y1. This depth of water flow is the pressure head. Then before the hydraulic jump, the velocity of water flow is v1. Then after the hydraulic jump, depth of water flow is y2, pressure head. Then after the hydraulic jump, velocity of water flow is v2. Take q is the discharge of water flow in this hydraulic jump. A1 is the wetted area before the hydraulic jump. A2 is the wetted area after the hydraulic jump. Then before the hydraulic jump, that is at section 1, the specific energy of water flow. In the unit 1, I discussed the specific energy of water flow. So before the hydraulic jump, the specific energy of water flow. We know that the specific energy is equal to the pressure head, that is the depth of water flow, plus the velocity head V square by 2z. So before the hydraulic jump, the specific energy of water flow E1 is equal to Y1 plus V1 square by 2z. The specific energy is the sum of the pressure head plus the kinetic head. So at section 1, before the hydraulic jump, the specific energy E1 is equal to Y1 plus V1 square by 2z. But you know that the velocity V1 is equal to discharge Q divided by wetted area A1. So in the place of V1, write Q by A1. This equation changes as Y1 plus Q square by 2z into A1 square, because V1 is equal to Q by A1. Since we are in rectangular channel, since we consider the hydraulic jump in rectangular channel, the wetted area in the rectangular channel is width B into depth of flow Y. A is equal to BY. So here this A1, the wetted area A1 is equal to V into Y1. So this equation of specific energy E1 is equal to Y1 plus Q square by 2Z into A1 square. That A1 square is B square into Y1 square. Then you know that capital Q square by capital B square is small Q square. Discharge per unit width. So at section 1, before the hydraulic jump, in the supercritical condition in rectangular channel, the specific energy of water flow E1 is equal to Y1 plus Q square by 2Z into Y1 square. This is the equation of specific energy of water flow before the hydraulic jump in the supercritical condition in the rectangular open channel. Then after the hydraulic jump, that is at section 2, the specific energy of water flow E2 is equal to, after the hydraulic jump, depth of flow is Y2. So the pressure head is Y2. After the hydraulic jump, the velocity of flow is V2. So the kinetic head is V2 square by 2Z. So after the hydraulic jump, the specific energy of water flow E2 is equal to Y2 plus V2 square by 2Z. This velocity V2 is equal to discharge by area A2, so Q by A2 square. So E2 is equal to Y2 plus Q square by 2Z A2 square. Since it is in the, since the hydraulic jump is in rectangular channel, the wetted area A2 is equal to width B into depth of flow Y2. So A2 square is B square into Y2 square. Q square by B square is the discharge per unit width. So at section 2, after the hydraulic jump, in the subcritical condition in rectangular channel, the specific energy of water flow E2 is equal to Y2 plus Q square by 2Z into Y2 square. So check the equations of E1 and E2. E1 is the specific energy of water flow at section 1 before the hydraulic jump in supercritical condition in the rectangular channel. E2 is the specific energy of water flow at section 2 after the hydraulic jump in the subcritical condition in the rectangular channel. Then from these two equations, E1, E2, we can find out the loss of energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump. Take delta E as the loss of energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump. That loss of energy delta E is equal to E1 minus E2, because E1 is the specific energy in the supercritical condition, large value. E2 is the specific energy in the subcritical condition, lesser value. So the loss of energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump is given by, in the rectangular channel, is given by E1 minus E2. On this right side, substitute these equations. E1 is Y1 plus Q square by 2Z Y1 square. E2 is Y2 plus Q square by 2Z Y2 square. Please remember, in the today's class, I explained the previous class concept. We know that from the specific force F1 is equal to F2, we got this relation. Please keep this relation in the mind. Just in the today's class, at the beginning, I explained this derivation. Yesterday, we discussed this derivation. This is the rectangular channel hydraulic from the specific force concept F1 is equal to F2. From that F1 is equal to F2, we got this equation. This is equation 2. This is the equation 2 we discussed in the last class. 2q square by z is equal to y1 by 2 into y2 plus y1. Keep this equation in the mind. We are going to discuss the derivation of loss of energy delta E in the hydraulic jump. Then substitute this E1 as y1 plus 2 square by 2z y1 square. Substitute this E2 as y2 plus 2 square by 2z y2 square. The delta E equation becomes as. Please, from this onwards, follow the steps carefully. Loss of energy delta E in the hydraulic jump is equal to E1, that is y1 plus 2 square by 2z y1 square, minus E2, that is y2 plus 2 square by 2z y2 square. Then keep these two terms in one side. Keep the two terms in one side, remaining terms adjacent. So just to simplify this equation, in this equation, q square by 2z y1 square positive, q square by 2z y1 square, minus into plus minus. So this term is negative, minus q square by 2z into y2 square. Here y1 is positive plus y1, y2 is negative minus y2. So just modify this equation, you will get this form of the equation. Delta E is equal to, what is delta E? The loss of energy in the hydraulic jump. The loss of energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump, delta E is equal to q square by 2z y1 square minus q square by 2z y2 square plus y1 minus y2. From these two terms, take q square by 2z as common. From these two terms, take q square by 2z as common. You will get this form. So delta E is equal to 2 square by 2z into 1 by y1 square minus 1 by y2 square. So take from these two terms, 2 square by 2z as common, you will get this form of equation. Delta E is equal to 2 square by 2z into 1 by y1 square minus 1 by y2 square. Just to modify this equation, take minus as common from these two terms. Take minus as common. Then this y2 becomes positive, y1 becomes negative. So in these two terms, take minus as the common, then these two terms becomes as y2 minus y1. So just to modify this right hand side of this above equation, take q square by 2z common from the two terms, take the minus common from the remaining two terms, you will get this form. Delta E is equal to q square by 2z into 1 by y1 minus 1 by y1 square minus 1 by y2 square minus of y2 minus y1. Then in this brackets, take y1 square y2 square as LCM. Here take y1 square y2 square as LCM. This equation becomes as delta E is equal to q square by 2z into y2 square minus y1 square in the numerator, divided by y1 square into y2 square in the denominator, minus of y2 minus y1 equation 2. In these three steps, if you have any doubts, you please ask me. So please follow these steps carefully. This is E1. This is the E1 expression. E1 is the specific energy of water flow before the hydraulic jump, in the supercritical condition, in rectangular channel. This is E2 expression. The second one is E2 expression. E2 is the specific energy of water flow after the hydraulic jump, in subcritical condition, in the rectangular channel. We modify this equation and we got this one. Then we consider the q square by 2z common in the two terms. minus common in the remaining two terms, we will get this equation. Take y1 square, y2 square as LCM, you will get this final equation 2. Delta E is equal to 2 square by 2z into y2 square minus y1 square by y1 square into y2 square minus of y2 minus y1. Please remember this 2 square by 2z. Please remember this 2 square by 2z. In the rectangular channel hydraulic jump, that 2 square by 2z is equal to 2 square by 2z, we know, is equal to y1 y2 into y2 plus y1. Please keep that in the mind. We are going to discuss after the equation 2 the loss of energy delta E. So the loss of energy delta E is equal to, we know that q square by 2z is equal to, check this one please, we know that q square by 2z is equal to, yes, now here we know that this q square by 2z is equal to, what is that q square by 2z? Just now I explained to you, q square by 2z is equal to y1 y2 into y2 plus y1. Substitute this equation 1 in the equation 2. According to equation 1, we discussed this in the last class, q square by 2z is y1 y2 into y2 plus y1. Substitute that here, q square by 2z here, q square by 2z, y1 y2 into y2 plus y1, then this equation delta E. The equation of delta E is equal to, what is q square by 2z? Y1 y2 into y2 plus y1 divided by 4 into y2 square minus y1 square divided by y1 square into y2 square. So please follow this. We know that 2q square by z, dear student, this is important. We know that 2q square by z is equal to y1 y2 into y1 plus y2. But here we have 2 square by 2z, not 2q square by z. Equation 1, 2q square by z is equal to y1 y2 into y1 plus y2. But here we have 2q square by 2z. So this q square by 2z is equal to 1 by 4 into y1 y2 into y1 plus y2. Most of the students get confused here. So don't confuse about that step. So check this one please, everyone. 2q square by z is equal to y1 y2 into y1 plus y2. But in that equation 2, we have q square by 2z, not 2q square by z. Otherwise, please follow this. 2q square by z is equal to y1 y2 into y1 plus y2. So q square by z is equal to, from this, q square by z is equal to y1 by 2 into y1 plus y2 by 2. Then q square by 2z is equal to, from this equation 1, q square by 2z is equal to 1 by 4 into y1 by 2 into y1 plus y2. Substitute that in that equation, in that delta E equation. What is this delta E? Q square by 2z into y2 square minus y1 square divided by y1 square into y2 square minus of y2 minus y1. But this q square by 2z is equal to, this value of q square by 2z is equal to y1 by 2 into y1 plus y2 by 4. Substitute that in the equation 2. Then this is q square by 2z. So delta E is equal to, the loss of energy delta E is equal to y1 by 2 into y1 plus y2 divided by 4 into y2 square minus y1 square divided by y1 square into y2 square minus of y2 minus y1. Cancel this y1 by 2 in the first term. Cancel y1 by 2 in the denominator and numerator. Then this first term becomes as, the entire first term after the cancellation becomes as y1 y2 into y2 square minus y1 square divided by 4 into y1 y2. So cancel this y1 y2 in the first term. Then this first term becomes as y2 plus y1 into y2 square minus y1 square divided by 4 y1 y2 minus of y2 minus y1. Then take this 4 y1 y2 as LCM on this entire right side. Take this 4 y1 y2 as LCM on the entire right side. This right side becomes as delta E is equal to first term as it is. Delta E is equal to y2 plus y1 into y2 square minus y1 square minus of 4 y1 y2, that is this LCM. 4 y1 y2 into y2 minus y1 by 4 y1 y2 up to this equation of delta E. If you have the doubts, you please ask me. I am explaining the loss of energy of water flow in the hydraulic jam. So first we calculated the specific energies E1, E2 before the hydraulic jump and after the hydraulic jump, specific energies. Then by using those specific energies, we determine the loss of energy. Delta E is equal to E1 minus E2, delta E, E1 minus E2. We substitute those values of E1, E2. We substitute those values of E1, E2 from that previous equation. Then delta E becomes as, this is that delta E. This is E1, E2. Simplify that, you will get this delta E. 2 square by 2Z into Y2 square minus Y1 square by Y1 square Y2 square minus of Y2 minus Y1. But 2 square by 2Z is equal to Y1 by 2 into Y2 plus Y1 by 4. Substitute that in this equation 2. 2 square by 2Z. This is that substitution. 2 square by 2Z is Y1 by 2 into Y2 plus Y1 divided by 4 into the remaining terms. Then check this simplification carefully. Check the simplification. Cancel this y1 y2 in the first term. Then the first term becomes as y2 plus y1 into y2 square minus y1 square divided by 4 y1 y2 minus of y2 minus y1. Take this 4 y1 y2 common for the two terms. Take this 4 y1 y2 common for the two terms. This right side now becomes as delta E is equal plus y1 into y2 square minus of 4 y1 y2 y2 minus y1 by 4 y1 y2. Expand this right hand side. Expand this right hand side. It is y2 into y2 square, y2 cube. Then minus of y2 into y1 square. Like that, expand this right hand side numerator. So check that expansion. Expand the right hand side numerator, you will get y2 cube minus y2 into y1 square plus y2 square into y1 minus y1 cube minus, and also the second term. In that second term, check the second term. In the second term, we have, this is the second term. In the second term, it is minus 4 y1 into y2 square minus into minus plus plus 4 y2 into y1 square. So expand this entire numerator on the right hand side, you will get like this. Delta E is equal to y2 cube minus y1 square into y2 plus y2 square into y1 minus y1 cube minus 4 y2 square into y1 plus 4 y1 square into y2. So check this y2 square, it is minus 4 y2 square y1 plus y2 square y1. So from these two terms, from these two terms, you will get it as minus 3 y2 square y1. So check these two terms. The first term, y2 square y1 positive. This is minus 4 y2 square y1. So from these two terms, you will get minus 3 y2 square y1. Similarly, this is plus 4 y1 square y2. And we have minus y1 square y2. So this is minus y1 square y2. This is plus 4 y1 square y2 from this term and also from this term. You will get it as plus 3 y1 square y2. So simplify this numerator further. Simplify this numerator further. You will get the equation as y2 cube minus 3 y2 square y1 plus 3 y1 square y2 minus y1 cube. This is a simplification. simplify this numerator, you will get this final result, y2 cube minus 3 y1 square y2 square y1 plus 3 y1 square y2 minus y1 cube. Please check this equation. This equation is in the form of a cube minus 3 a square b plus 3 ab square minus b cube. This numerator is in the form of a cube minus 3 a square b plus 3 a b square minus b cube. This is a minus b whole cube. This equation is a minus b whole cube. So this equation is y2 minus y1 whole cube. So the energy loss delta E in the hydraulic jump, the loss of energy delta E is equal to y2 minus y1 whole cube divided by 4y1 by 2. This is the equation of loss of energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump. In this equation 3, y1 is the depth of water flow before the hydraulic jump. Y2 is the depth of water flow after the hydraulic jump. So the equation 3 gives the loss of energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump in terms of the depth of flows y1 and y2. So in the today's class, we started this expression for the loss of energy of water flow in hydraulic jump in the rectangular channel. In this discussion, first we calculated the specific energies E1, E2 before the hydraulic jump, after the hydraulic jump, specific energies. Then we calculated the loss of energy E1 minus E2. E1 is equal to y1 plus 2 square by 2z y1 square. E2 is equal to y2 plus 2 square by 2z y2 square. We substitute these equations on the right side. Then we simplify the right hand side. We simplify this right hand side, you will get this right hand side. Delta E is equal to 2 square by 2z y2 square minus y1 square by y1 square into y2 square minus of y2 minus y1. We know that this 2 square by 2z, the 2 square by 2z is equal to y1 y2 into y2 plus y1 divided by 4. That is this form. y1 y2 into y1 plus y2 by 4. Then the remaining terms same. Cancel this y1 y2 in the first term in numerator and denominator. Then the first term becomes as y2 plus y1 into y2 square minus y1 square by 4 y1 y2 minus of y2 minus y1. Take this 4 y1 y2 as LCM in the right side. Then this equation becomes as delta E is equal to y2 plus y1 into y2 square minus y1 square minus of 4 y1 y2 into y2 minus y1 by 4 y1 y2. Expand this numerator. Expand this only the numerator. That expansion is like this. Expand the only numerator, it is y2 cube minus y1 square y2 plus y2 square y1 minus y1 cube minus 4 y2 square y1 plus 4 y1 square y2. Check the terms, it is minus 4 y2 square y1. This is a plus y2 square y1. So from this term and also from this term, you will get this two terms. From the two terms, you will get the value as minus 3 y2 square y1, because it is minus 4 y2 square y1 plus y2 square y1. So the result is minus 3 y2 square y1. Then the next one, 4 y1 square y2 plus 4 y1 square y2 minus y1 square y2. So from these two terms, from this last term and from this second term, from these two terms, you will get the result as plus 3 y1 square y2. So this numerator, after the simplification, the numerator becomes as y2 cube minus 3 y2 square y1 plus 3 y1 square y2 minus y1 cube. This numerator is a minus b whole cube equation. This numerator is a minus b whole cube. So I can write this numerator as y2 minus y1 whole cube divided by 4 y1 y2. This is the expression for the loss of energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump in rectangular channel. Delta E is equal to 4 delta E is equal to y2 minus y1 whole cube divided by 4 y1 y2. So by using that equation 3, you can calculate the loss of energy of water flow in the hydraulic jam. In that equation 3, y1 is depth of water flow before the hydraulic jam. Y2 is depth of water flow after the hydraulic jam. So dear students, up to that derivation of delta E, check that equation 3. Here this delta E is in terms of depth of water flows. We discuss the derivation of delta E in terms of the depth of water flow, y1 and y2. So up to this delta E derivation, if anybody is having doubts, you please discuss with me. Up to this equation 3, derivation of this equation 3, in this equation 3, we derive this loss of energy delta E in terms of the depth of water flow y1 and y2. So if anybody is having doubt in that derivation of delta E, you please discuss with me. Any doubts, students, up to that delta E derivation? If you have any doubts, you please bring it to my notice. Any doubts? One person respond, very good. Pavan Kalyan also respond, very good. What about remaining? If you have any doubt about that derivation of delta E in terms of the depth of flow y1, y2, you please bring that doubts to my notice. Okay, thank you. So please understand that equation 3. In that equation 3, we derive the loss of energy of water flow in hydraulic jam in terms of the depth of water flows y1 and y2. Then the same loss of energy delta E, the same loss of energy delta E can also be expressed in terms of the velocity of water flows v1, v2. In the equation 3, delta E expression is in terms of y1, y2. But the same delta E expression is also obtained in terms of the velocity of water flows v1, v2. We know that before the hydraulic jump, before the hydraulic jump, the velocity of water flow is v1. After the hydraulic jump, the velocity of water flow is v2. We can also obtain the equation of delta E, that is loss of energy in terms of the velocities of water flow before the hydraulic jump and after the hydraulic jump. Now please go through the derivation. What is this delta E in terms of the velocity of water flow v1 and v2? We know that the loss of energy delta E is equal to E1 minus E2. Now I am going to discuss with you the loss of energy delta E in terms of the velocities of water flow v1, v2. So go through this explanation. We consider the channel as a rectangular channel. Take B is the width of the rectangular channel. Take Q is the discharge of water flow in the hydraulic jam, capital Q. At section 1, before the hydraulic jam, velocity of water flow is V1, that is in the supercritical condition. After the hydraulic jump, velocity of water flow is V2. Then the discharge of water flow per unit width, that is small q. The discharge of water flow per unit width is equal to capital Q by B. Capital Q is the total discharge. Small q is the discharge per unit width. So check that carefully. we are going to discuss the derivation of delta E in terms of the velocities V1, V2. So we consider the channel as a rectangular channel. Width is B. Q is the discharge of water flow in the hydraulic jump. Then V1 is the velocity in the supercritical condition before the hydraulic jump at section 1. V2 is the velocity in the subcritical condition at section 2 after the hydraulic jump. Small q is the discharge per unit width, capital Q by B. Since the channel is a rectangular channel, at section 1, the wetted area A1 is equal to V into Y1. Please follow this carefully. The channel is a rectangular channel, so the wetted area at section 1, A1 is equal to V into Y1. At section 2, the wetted area V into Y2. In the rectangular channel, wetted area width into depth of flow. You know that small q, discharge per unit width, small q is equal to capital Q by B. Capital Q is the discharge. According to continuity equation, the discharge Q is equal to area into velocity. So you know that according to continuity equation, the discharge Q is area at section 1. The discharge Q A1 into V1. At section 2, the discharge Q A2 into V2. So small q is equal to discharge per unit width. Small q is equal to capital Q by B. That is equal to A1 V1 by B at section 1. That is equal to A2 V2 by B at section 1. So small q is equal to what is A1 B into Y1. That is A1 wetted area. So A1 is B into Y1 into V1 by B. What is A2 at section 2 wetted area? B into Y2. So B into Y2 into V2 by B. So follow this modifications carefully. The discharge per unit width small q is equal to discharge per unit width small q is equal to capital Q by B. At section 1, capital Q discharge is area into velocity A1 into V1. At section 2, the discharge Q, area into velocity, A2 into V2. A1 is equal to B into Y1. A2 is equal to B into Y2. So small q is equal to B into Y1 into V1 by B. It is also equal to B into Y2 into V2 by B. So the B will cancel. The B will cancel in the two terms. So the discharge Q, small q, the discharge per unit width, small q is equal to Y1 into V1. It is also equal to Y2 into V2. From this equation, Y1 is equal to the depth of flow at section 1. Y1 is equal to small q divided by V1. Y2 is equal to small q divided by V2. So everyone follow this derivation carefully. I am going to discuss with you the loss of energy delta E in terms of the velocity of water flow V1, V2. So first I consider this discharge per unit width, small q, capital Q by B. Capital Q is equal to A1, V1. It is also equal to A2, V2. A1 is equal to B into Y1. A2 is equal to B into Y2. Cancel this B. You will get this small q is equal to Y1, V1 and also equal to Y2, V2 from this. Y1 is equal to Q by V1 and Y2 is equal to Q by V2. Then coming to that equation 3. Equation 3, just now we discussed. In the equation 3, delta E is equal to, we know that from equation 3, delta E is equal to Y2 minus Y1 whole cube by 4 Y1 Y2. What is delta E equation? Y2 minus Y1 whole cube by 4 Y1 Y2. Just now we discussed Y2 is equal to small q. Y2 is equal to small q divided by V2. Y2 is equal to small q divided by V2. Y1 is equal to small q divided by V1. Substitute that in the equation 3. On the right hand side, this is equation 3 we discuss. According to equation 3, loss of energy delta E, Y2 minus Y1 whole cube by 4 y1 y2. Just now we discuss in the rectangular channel, depth y2 is equal to small q by v2. Depth y1 is equal to small q by v1. Substitute them in this equation 3. y2 is equal to small q by v2 and y1 is equal to small q by v1. Simplify the right hand side, you will get the equation for delta E in terms of the velocity of water flow. So in this right hand side of equation 3, substitute that y1, just now we discussed, y1 is equal to q by v1, y2 is equal to q by v2. Substitute that on the right hand side of equation 3. So in the equation 3, substitute y2 q by v2, substitute y1 q by v1. Simplify this right hand side, you will get the loss of energy of water flow in hydraulic jump in terms of the velocity of water flow v1 v2. So I am giving this as homework for you. I discussed with you about the derivation of y1 and y2. Y1 is equal to small q by v1, y2 is equal to small q by v2. Substitute that values in the equation 3. Simplify the right hand side, you will get the loss of energy delta E in terms of the depth of water flows, the velocity of water flows v1 and v2. I will show that calculation also. Please go through that calculation. I will show you that calculation. Please go through that calculation of delta E, derivation of delta E in terms of the velocity of water flow v1 and v2. I will show that remaining calculation. Actually, I plan to do it as homework. Do it as homework also, because you know delta E is equal to y2 minus y1 whole cube by 4 y1 y2. Since you know that, and y1 is q by v1, y2 is q by v2. Substitute those y1 y2 values in the equation 3, you will get the form of equation 3 in terms of the velocity of flow v1 v2. So dear students, can you see this Word document on the cell phones? Give me the response. Can you see this Word document on the cell phones?
Yes sir.
Okay ma'am, please everyone go through this derivation of delta E in terms of velocity of flow v1 v2. Just now I explained in the PPT. In the PPT I explained in rectangular channel, y1 is equal to q by v1. This is equation 4. Y1 is equal to q by v1. Y2 is equal to q by v2. Then substitute that equation 4 in equation 3. So check this please, calculation. So you know that otherwise. Coming to the specific energies, please. Coming to the specific energies, we know that E1 is equal to, at section 1, the specific energy E1 is equal to Y1 plus V1 square by 2Z. At section 2, the specific energy E2 is equal to Y2 plus V2 square by 2Z. By using the equation 3, you will get that delta E derivation. Also, the another way is, I am going to apply the specific energies again. At section 1, the specific energy y1 plus v1 square by 2z. At section 2, the specific energy y2 plus v2 square by 2z. Then the loss of energy from section 1 to section 2, delta E is equal to E1 minus E2. E1 is y1 plus v1 square by 2z. E2 is y2 plus v2 square by 2z. Substitute that here. So E1 minus E2. What is E1? Y1 plus V1 square by 2Z. What is E2? Y2 plus V2 square by 2Z. So delta E is equal to So this is the equation of delta E. Delta E is equal to E1 minus E2, that is equal to Y1 plus V1 square by 2Z minus Y2 minus V2 square by 2Z. Bring the velocity terms in one side, the y1, y2 on the other side. So this equation becomes as v1 square minus v2 square by 2z. Because v1 square by 2z positive, v2 square by 2z negative, delta E is equal to v1 square minus v2 square by 2z minus of y2 minus y1 minus y2 plus y1. Take this minus common, so it becomes as y2 minus y1. So check this simplification carefully. I am using the specific energies to prepare the equations of delta E in terms of the velocity V1, V2. So delta E is equal to E1 minus E2. E1 is equal to Y1 plus V1 square by 2Z. E2 is equal to Y2 plus V2 square by 2Z. So the loss of energy delta E E1 minus E2. E1 is Y1 plus V1 square by 2Z minus E2. So that minus E2 becomes as minus Y2 minus V2 square by 2Z. Take these two velocities as one term. So they are V1 square by 2Z minus V2 square by 2Z is V1 square minus V2, V1 square minus V2 square by 2Z minus of Y2 minus Y1, equation 5. Then from equation 4, we know that Y2 is equal to small q by V1, V2. Y2 is equal to small q by V2.
Sir, Y1 Y2 is plus equal V2 to square by 2Z, sir. E2 on it.
Substitute that here. We know that from equation 4, Y2 is equal to small q by V2. Y1 is equal to small q by V1. Substitute the equation 4 in equation 5. Simplify that. Delta E is equal to V1 square minus V2 square by 2Z minus of what is Y2 Q by V2, what is Y1 Q by V1. Take this Q common in the two terms, last two terms. Take this Q common, then this equation becomes as V1 square minus V2 square by 2Z minus small q into 1 by V2 minus 1 by V1. So in the two terms, last two terms, take this small q as common. So take that small q as common. This equation becomes as V1 square minus V2 square by 2Z minus small q into 1 by V2 minus 1 by V1. In this term, last term, take V1, V2 as LCM. In the last term, take V1, V2 as LCM. Then the equation, this above equation becomes as, delta E is equal to V1 square minus V2 square by 2Z minus small q. Minus small q into, take V1, V2 common here, this term becomes as V1 minus V2 by V1, V2. This is the last term, take in this term, V1, V2 as common. So if I take V1, V2 as common in this term becomes as V1 minus V2 by V1, V2. So by simplifying this above equation, we got the equation 6. So delta E is equal to V1 square minus V2 square by 2Z minus small q into V1 minus V2 by V2 V1 or V1 V2. Then from equation 1, we discuss in hydraulic jump. In hydraulic jump, 2Q square by Z. In the today's class also, I stressed this. 2Q square by Z is equal to Y1 Y2 into Y2 plus Y1. This is already we discussed in the last class. In the today's class also, I repeated this derivation. 2q square by z is equal to y1 y2 into y2 plus y1. But we know that in hydraulic jump of rectangular channel, y1 is equal to q by v1. So please follow this. y1 is equal to q by v1. y2 is equal to q by v2. So substitute that in the right hand side. So 2q square by z is equal to 2 by V1, that is Y1, into 2 by V2, that is Y2, into Q by V2, that is Y2, plus Q by V1, Y1. Simplify this right-hand side. So, we have Q into Q, Q square. So, check this please. Q into Q, Q square, divided by V1, V2. And from this term, take small q as common, from these two terms. So, small q into 1 by V2 plus 1 by V1. So simplify this right hand side. Q square, this is Q square. Q by V1 into Q by V2. So Q square by V1 V2 into, take the Q common from the two terms. So it is Q into 1 by V2 plus 1 by V1. Take V1 V2 as LCM in this term. Take V1 V2 as LCM. Then you will get this 2Q square by Z is equal to. 2Q square by Z is equal to Q square into Q. Check this carefully. Q square into Q is Q cube. And here, v1 v2 as LCM. So this equation becomes as v1 plus v2 by v1 v2. So here we have one v1 v2 and also another v1 v2. So I am taking v1 v2 as LCM here. Q square into Q is Q cube. So 2Q square by Z, 2Q square by Z is equal to Q cube divided by V1 V2 into, take V1 V2 as LCM here, this equation becomes as V1 plus V1 V2. Cancel this Q on both sides, cancel the Q on both sides, Q square and Q cube, Q is on the right side, so 2 by Z is equal to Q by V1 square V2 square into V1 plus V2. From this equation, find out this small q. From this equation, calculate small q, you will get the small q is equal to, from this equation, small q is equal to 2 by z into v1 square into v2 square divided by v1 plus v2. So we consider this equation 2, 2q square by z is equal to y1 by 2 into y2 plus y1, and in this right hand side we substituted y1 is equal to q by v1, y2 is equal to q by v2, then we simplify the right hand side. After that cancellation, you are getting this final form, small q is equal to 2 into v1 square into v2 square by z into v1 plus v2. Substitute this equation 7 in equation 6. In the equation 6, right hand side, we have the small q. So in the place of small q in the equation 6, substitute this equation 7. What is that equation 7? Equation 7 is q is equal to 2 into v1 square into v2 square divided by z into v1 plus v2. Substitute that in the equation 6 in the place of q. Then delta E is equal to the equation for loss of energy. Delta E is equal to v1 square minus v2 square by 2z minus small q. What is that small q? 2 into v1 square into v2 square by z into v1 plus v2 into v1 minus v2 by v1 v2. Cancel this v1 v2 in the second term, in the numerator and denominator. Then this right hand side, after the cancellation, becomes as delta E is equal to v1 square minus v2 square by 2z minus 2 into v1 v2. 1 v1 v2 is cancelled. Minus 2 into v1 v2 by z. And here we have v1 minus v2. V1 plus v2. That is the common. V1 minus v2 by v1 plus v2. Then take this right hand side, complete right hand side. In this right hand side, in the entire right hand side, take 2z into v1 plus v2 as common. On the right hand side, take 2z into v1 plus v2 as common. That is this LCM. In this right hand side, take 2z into v1 plus v2 as LCM. Then delta E is equal to, after the LCM, on the right hand side, delta E is equal to, the first term is v1 plus v2 into v1 square minus v2 square, because we have 2z already in the first term. So this v1 plus v2 goes to the numerator in the first term. So delta E is equal to v1 plus v2 into v1 square minus v2 square minus, here we have only z, whereas in the LCM we have 2z. So 2 into 2 is 4. 4 into v1 v2 into v2. So in this right hand side, take 2z into v1 plus v2 LCM, you will get this right hand side like that. Delta E is equal to v1 plus v2 into v1 square minus v2 square minus 4 v1 v2 into v1 minus v2. Expand only this numerator. Expand the numerator in the right hand side. In that numerator expansion, you will get the term like this. Delta E is equal to v1 cube minus v1 v1 v2 square plus v2 v1 square minus v2 cube plus minus 4 v2 v1 cube plus 4 v1 v2 cube. So expand the right hand side on the numerator. You will get this numerator on the right hand side. Simplify this right hand side numerator. It is 4. It is plus 4 v1 v2 square followed by minus v1 v2 square. So it is plus 3 V1 V2 square. Then the next one is minus 4 V2 V1 square followed by plus V2 V1 square. It is minus 3. Minus 3 V1 square V2. So simplify the numerator. You will get that numerator as V1 cube minus 3 V1 square V2 plus 3 V1 V2 square minus V2 cube. Observe this numerator. The numerator is in the form of A minus B whole cube. So the numerator on the right hand side is V1 minus V2 whole cube. The denominator is 2Z into V1 plus V2. So the equation of delta E in terms of the velocity of water flow. In the previous equation, we discussed the delta E in terms of the depth of water flow Y1, Y2. Is in the previous discussion, delta E is equal to Y2 minus Y1 whole cube by 4 Y1, Y2. Whereas the same delta E can also be obtained in velocities V1, V2. That is equation 8. In the hydraulic jump in rectangular channel, the loss of energy of water flow delta E is equal to V1 minus V2 whole cube by 2Z into V1 plus V2. So like that we have two equations for the loss of energy delta E in hydraulic jump. One is in terms of the depth of flow Y1 Y2. Other one is in terms of the velocity of flow V1 V2. These two derivations are important in the examination point of view. Sometimes they ask us to derive the equation of delta E in hydraulic jump in terms of the depth of flow Y1 Y2. Sometimes they ask us to derive the equation of delta E in hydraulic jump in terms of the velocity of water flow V1 V2. Okay, students, with this I am going to stop this today's class. Next class also I will revise this delta E derivation since it is important. In the tomorrow class also I will revise this delta E derivation both in terms of the depth of water flow and also in terms of the velocity of water flow. So with this I am going to stop the today's class. If you have any doubts, you please discuss with me. Otherwise you please leave from this class. If you have any doubts in this derivation of delta E, either in terms of depth of flow or in terms of velocity of flow. In both cases, either in depth of flow or in velocity of flow, we consider the specific energies E1, E2 before the hydraulic jump and after the hydraulic jump. We suitably modify that equations E1, E2 and we got the equations of delta E in terms of the depth of flow and also in terms of the velocity of flow. So if you don't have any doubts, you please leave from the class. If anybody is having doubts, you please discuss with me.